Several months back, Blackmagic Design introduced voice isolation and dialogue leather for Davinci Resolve, which was a great addition. However, that addition also came with a lot of frustration, especially from non-Davinci Resolve Studio users. But that frustration should end right now, because there is a great free plugin that does exactly the same thing as the voice isolation feature, with a lot more controls. So I prepared a little timeline right here with two audio clips. On audio track number 2, I got the voice isolation and the dialogue leveler applied. And on audio track number 3, we got the Goyo plugin for DaVinci Resolve or any other digital audio workstation. So let's hear what the raw recording sounds like.
Yeah, ich habe gerade bei der Nature One gespielt. Es war richtig verrückt. Hey Freunde, heute machen wir das SMS und ich habe hier im Hintergrund seht.
And as you can tell, there is a lot of background noise and music going on, but for now, let's solo audio layer number 2 and see what the voice isolation and the dialogue leveler sounds like. But first up, we're gonna check out the settings. For voice isolation, I reduced the amount from 100% to 89%, and for the dialogue leveler, I did nothing except activating it. So this is what the audio track number 2 sounds like.
Yeah, ich habe gerade bei der Nature One gespielt. Es war richtig verrückt. Hey Freunde, heute machen wir das SMS und ich habe hier im Hintergrund seht.
As you can tell, this does a pretty good job of cutting out the background and ambience noise and the music in the background. But now let's solo audio layer number 3 to check out what the free Goyo plugin sounds like.
Yeah, ich habe gerade bei der Nature One gespielt. Es war richtig verrückt. Hey Freunde, heute machen wir das SMS und ich habe hier im Hintergrund seht.
But now let's bring up the effect panel to see what kind of controls we actually have using the Goyo plugin. So let's come over to your inspector in the top right corner, click on effects, and then down here, click on those dots. And this is what it looks like when you open up the Goyo plugin. And you get individual control over the ambience, you get individual control over the voice, and you get individual control over the voice reverberation. And if I'm gonna solo the voice...
Yeah, ich habe gerade bei der Nature One gespielt. Es war richtig verrückt.
This does exactly the same thing as the voice isolation in DaVinci Resolve. However, if you're gonna solo the ambience, all you gotta hear is just the ambient soundings. And why I think this plugin might even be better than the voice isolation from DaVinci Resolve is because you don't want to cut out the background noise and music completely. Because if you cut out the ambience and the background completely, chances are you're gonna cut out a lot of frequencies from the voice as well. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lower the ambience just by around 17 dB and I'm gonna up my voice to around, let's go with around 4.2. And then have a listen to what that actually sounds like.
Yeah, ich habe gerade bei der Nature One gespielt. Es war richtig verrückt.
And as you can tell, we got a little bit of ambience and background noise going on, but that is totally fine because it's so quiet that it's not distracting. However, we still preserve like the whole voice spectrum, so we're not gonna cut out any of the frequencies to make the voice sound unnatural. So I don't want to make this video too long. If you're interested in getting the Goyo plugin, it is free and you can find it using the link in the description of this video or in the pinned comment. And this is not an affiliate link, nor is this video sponsored by Goyo. This is just a plugin that I found would be worth sharing. However, there's two more things that I want to talk about. First up, nothing is entirely for free. So if you click the link in the description, you will get redirected to the Goyo website. However, you can just download it from there. You have to enter your email address and the download link will be sent to your email address within 2 to 5 minutes. And one last thing, if you don't read the terms of service, there is a paragraph stating that they will track the usage of how this plugin has been used, but they don't state quite why they're doing this. I assume that they're doing is to make it more user-friendly and to see what they could improve on. However, that is totally just an assumption. But anyways, hope this video was helpful to you and I'm gonna see you next week. Bye.